Right, so this is day two of the Zelkova repot and prune. It's Easter Sunday today. You've had a frost overnight. It's quite a sharp one. I'll just zoom in on the bench there. You can see the frost there. So hopefully all the trees that I did yesterday are going to be okay. So I have put them under some shelter, so all the roots that have been pruned are hopefully going to be good. So we'll just have to keep an eye on those for the next few days, see how they go. Right, so today we're going to repot the Zelkova. I found a training pot which is nice and deep. It's just about the right size for the tree. It's in it at the moment, so I put it in it overnight last night. So I'm going to take it out of there, put some new soil in, repot that, and then we'll get on with the pruning. As I say, we've had the frost, it's quite chilly. I've got two jumpers on, I've got two hoodies on, two woolly hats, pair of gloves. So let's carry on and see what we can do. Let's get the tree out of the pot and we'll start. It's just about 7:15 at the moment, so I thought I'd come out early today to get this done before any noise of people having barbecues and things like that. So let's carry on and see where we can go. So this is just all of the old soil that the tree was planted in before. So we'll just tee that out of the root. For that, let's just put that down there for a minute. Right, let's get rid of this soil. charge. I'm going to put a coarse layer of stones in the bottom just to help with drainage. Acadama. A little bit of that out so we can get the tree in. We're going to put some sphagnum moss in as well, that will help with root generation. So the sphagnum's already been soaking in water overnight. That should be fine. Water and all. There we go. They've messed around. Nice, we'll spread that out. That makes nice contact with the root ball. Perfect. Right. Plant the tree. I'm not going to take any more root off. I've taken plenty off as far as I can see. So it's only going into this training pot for now. So yeah, put it to one side like that. Right. Put it in there. Yeah, so I look at the angle. Yeah. That's better.
some more salt. Firm that in. Turn it around. This just firms down soil. You go round in a circle, tend to take it down to the bottom of the pot. It's going to help to firm the tree in, make sure there's no air pockets. getting firmer as you work. Pretty firm in there.
Right, we'll get a top dressing of Akadama to finish it off. Right, so that was about 3/4 of a bag of Akadama on there. Right, I'm just going to give it some water, just to water it in, and then we'll start on the pruning. So this is a can of water straight out of the koi pond. Well, that should be enough just to settle it in a little bit. Right. Right, that'll do for that. I'm going to grab the tag. On there when we repotted it. Tells us when we potted it last. Right, time for a coffee. Coffee and bonsai, who wants for more, eh? What a life. Sun's just coming up over the horizon. Should hopefully get a bit warmer soon.
Whoa, nice. Put that there. Right, scissors, side cutters, knob cutters. Keep them in there, I think. Nice and dry. Let's just put a stone in there just to weigh that down so it doesn't fall off. Right, so let's have a look at what we've got here. So at the moment I'm just going to go through, take all the really small, insignificant growth, I'm going to cut back to a couple of leaves, if they've already extended. That one looks dead. You can see by the ends of the leaves here that we've had a frost. I'm bent over slightly, so I'm just nipping them off. I don't know where to start on this, there's so much to cut off. I'll just start from the bottom and work my way up. So anything that's sort of pointing downwards is coming off. It's like a jungle, this. Corner. Thank you.
So I'm cutting all the tips off just to try and induce some back budding. This tree needs lots of refinement work, so with a bit of luck, if I can get the tree to back bud, that's going to give me lots more to work with in the future. It's going to be a long, slow job, but it's got to be done, so we'll just carry on going. So as I'm getting into the tree, I can actually see there's quite a lot of signs of back budding already, which is going to be good. So what I'm going to do is err on the side of caution. Some of the branches I'm going to leave a little bit longer than I want to at the moment, just to let those buds develop. And then when they do, we can see what directions they're going in, and we can select the one we need and train it in the direction we want it to go. If that's a sign of what the tree's going to do over the next few weeks, then it's all good for the tree at the moment. Like I say, the more back budding we can get, the better, because there are some very large branches on there that I would like to take off, but there's no point taking them off unless you've got something to replace them with. So if it's obviously dead, then it's going to come off. But if it's just a branch that's in the wrong position, I'm going to leave it until I see what develops further down the branch. So that's the reason for tipping all of the branches, is to put the energy back into the middle of the tree, further down the branch basically, just to see what the tree produces. At the end of the day, the tree wants to put out leaf, and if you're cutting about a third of it off probably at the moment, then obviously that's going to want to produce those leaves again. So the only way it's going to do it is by back budding. So hopefully in a few weeks time we'll come back to this tree and we do some more pruning. Let's carry on as we go.